You get me.
Yo, what's good, everybody? Back in the studio again. It's your boy Larry O, and today I wanted to run through some really dope tips on mixing vocals. This pertains to lining them up as far as layering. So if you have layers in your choruses or in your verses with doubles or multiple harmonies, you want to line those up. There are some plugins out there that do this automatically, but I find doing it manually is one of my favorite ways to do it, and I get the best results that way. So without further ado, we're going to jump right into this. I have a session already opened and started, and I'm gonna show you guys how to do that right now. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, if you get me. I have this session open right here. It's from my homie, his name is Silver. He's a local artist, rapper in my hometown of Providence. As you can see, he has a hook that has three layers and verses that have two layers pretty much all the way through. You know, just being human, you cannot possibly get those perfectly lined up just by doing them and recording them yourself. It's very hard to do that. There are always gonna be some like imperfections in the layering, and you're gonna hear those, especially when you go to pan something like a chorus. What I have right now in this chorus is I have these three tracks. First two of them panned left and right here, the other one in the middle. I have a bus here. When you start panning things, you're gonna hear those little imperfections a lot more. You're gonna want those nice and tight. I'm gonna show you guys how to do that. I mean, it's not like the easiest thing in the world. There are some plugins that do this, like I was saying before. Doing them manually, I find like I get the best results personally. I've gotten kind of quick at it. With some shortcuts, you'll get quicker with it too, and I'll try to like go through these like little keyboard shortcuts as I go. To highlight everything, a lot of you guys probably know, if you hold control and click and drag the mouse, it highlights everything all at once. First and foremost, what we're going to do is go into each of these tracks. They're already routed to the mixer. We're going to go into this track and we're going to go to declicking mode and turn on generic bleeding. Then we're going to do that for all of the vocal tracks. That's out of the way. And what that does is it gives a smooth crossfade, so you're not going to get any of those clicks and pops, anything like that, when you do a bunch of your audio clip chopping. Here's like a good rule of thumb. This is my middle track that's going to be, you know, in that chorus. It's kind of going to be like the main vocal. On this one and this one, these are the left and rights. I'm going to chop all of those, and this is like the easiest way to do it. The other thing too, these choruses, before they were sent to me, they were copy and pasted. So all three choruses are the same exact thing, except for this last one. It's just the doubled version of what the first and second choruses are. So we can literally just delete those just like that. Trim that up, and then we can work on lining up all of these vocals, and then we can just copy and paste them throughout the rest of the song to make it really easy. We'll go to the left track first, and we're gonna click this little menu in the top left, then go down to chop, and then we're gonna chop in beats, and then we're gonna do the same thing here on this track, chop in beats. Then you're gonna wanna zoom in to make this full screen. A good keyboard shortcut for zooming is holding the control key, scrolling the mouse wheel, and the alt key, and scrolling the mouse wheel up and down. Huge, huge time saver. All right, so we'll get that nice and trimmed up right there. You know, you can see already once you zoom in that these are out of line right here. What we're gonna do is hold the alt key to turn that snap off temporarily. That way you can get those nice and tight. And we're just gonna move these around and just go by with your eyes. To do this, most of the time, I don't even have to listen to anything. I might miss a couple of things. I'll listen back and see if I missed anything just by going off of ear. And you're gonna wanna make sure that you clean up any of these like little gaps. You might hear some little clicks and pop. And we're just gonna go through these tracks. If we see any things that are out of line, we're just gonna go around and nudge those. Clean that up right there. Right here, you can see that these might be breaths. Just double check. Do you wanna go? The other thing what I do is, if you have three layers of breaths, so as you can see, like, this is a breath right here, that's a breath, that's a breath. There's no real need to have three layers of breaths. So what I'm gonna do is, on the left and the right tracks, I'm gonna take the breaths out completely, wherever I see them and wherever we hear them. So we're gonna just take those out, and we're just gonna leave the breath that's in the middle, because you wanna keep that natural feel. By leaving that breath, it doesn't sound so robotic, it sounds natural still, but it just sounds nice and clean, because you lined everything up and you took away any extra breaths that are not needed. We're just gonna keep running through this. Anything that we see, we're gonna line up. So we're gonna get rid of those guys. Anything that you see that's off, and you can make more chops as well. Here's a good keyboard shortcut. If you hold Alt and go to C, it triggers your razor tool, and then you can hold the Alt key, and again, that turns your snap off, so you can just kind of cut wherever you want, and it's not gonna go strictly to the grid like it normally does. If you go like this, it'll just snap into that line. If you need to make more cuts as you go along, which I almost always do, that's how I do it with the razor tool. Super convenient. Nudge these guys around, make sure that those are nice and tight. You don't have to get these things absolutely perfect, because sometimes leaving them a little loose brings that real feel to it. And you know, as you like just train your eyes and your ears, you'll know what a breath looks like. By now, like, I don't even have to listen, I know that those are breaths again. You get used to what these waveforms look like. More breaths here, nudge those. pretty much have that chorus all lined up by eyesight. We're gonna listen back and see if I missed anything, see if we need to nudge anything else.
Unknown, unknown, do you wanna unload, unload? Do you wanna go home, tell you what you wanna know, cause I'm fucking with the unknown, unknown, do you wanna unload, unload? Do you wanna go home, tell you what you wanna know, cause I'm fucking with the...
Sounds really good. So now we can do the same thing to the verse. For the verses, what I like to do is go to the dub track, leave that main vocal track alone, like don't do any chops in that one because it's going to be your loudest one. So if you make any weird like cuts that sound choppy, you might not hear them in the dubs. If you do hear them, you can go in, fine tune and adjust those as well. Just like the other tracks in the chorus, we're going to do that. Go to this menu right here, chop, chop in beats, and then we're going to go through the same thing. Like I said, that's pretty much it, guys. The key is to get your vocal layers sounding nice and tight. I find that doing them manually, I get the best results. I've been doing it for a long time, so I've gotten really fast with it. The more practice you have, the more you do it, the better and the faster you get. So with that being said, guys, thank you for watching. Comment down below any suggestions that you have for new videos or any questions that you have on this video. Again, like, subscribe, comment, and share this with a friend if you get me.